Welcome back. I'm Zip Jacket Gamer, and this is Alan Wake. Now, last time we left off, Alan kind of got into a bad car accident, and we're trying to figure out like what the heck is going on. Sorry if I am slurping with my words a little bit. I woke up a few minutes ago, guys.
Damn.
Whoa. Where is the kaboom? I'm hearing for the earth-shattering kaboom! Oh crap, you can actually see the car still! Wow, there's a lot of games out there that doesn't allow you to see the cars. Like any, like, vehicles that the main character went in and... Wow. Dear gosh, this rock is so low polygon, but the game still looks pretty well. Alright. We're making our way towards a gas station. Let's see if we can get some help.
Hello?
Hello? Jesus, is that you?
Hello? Is someone there?
Oh, I don't like where this is going.
The loose sheets of paper were pages from a manuscript entitled Departure. That was the name I planned to use for the next novel I had never gotten started. I was named the author. I hadn't written it. I couldn't remember writing it. In the scene on the page, the hero was attacked by an axe murderer in the woods at night.
Huh? Oh! Boy! Oh, that's right. Yeah, you can, those are collectibles. You can read them within the story. But if you read these pages in the story, it can spoil what may happen, before you... Like,
the man turned to face me. His face was covered in shadows.
Yeah. If I click on these and look at them all one by one, it'll spoil what's gonna happen before it happens. Which I don't want to hear. I mean, it'll make the scene probably not too terrifying, but...
Anybody there? Please, I've been in an accident!
Ellen, shut up! The thing said an axe murderer! Dear gosh, this guy would have a brain if he written that character. Whoa, hold on a minute. So whatever this guy writes comes into existence then? I want $1 billion. I'll write that into existence.
The lights up ahead were a good sign. Maybe I wouldn't have to hike all the way down to the gas station to find a phone.
Cool. All right, let's go. Let's get in there. Maybe we can use this call for help.
Anybody there? Please, I've been in an accident.
Ellen, you're really, really stupid. Seriously.
Hey, you!
Phil!
There's been an accident. I need help.
Deposit.
Listen, I need to...
Premium cabins for rent in...
Oh, hell.
Carl Stuckey.
Pleased
to meet you. Non-refundable
reservation
deposit required.
Oh.
Fair and square.
Yeah, that's...
And
that's probably what I would look like. So the darkness got to Stuckey. He did get him in the bathroom. Oh, he killed the guy. Ooh. How do I get out of here? Ooh, manuscript. Thank you. Woo! Oh! Shiznick! Oh. Darn you, Stuckey! Oh, the camera. Oh, I was stuck by that. Oh, I'm running.
You lose.
Shit.
Go! Yes.
I had to figure a way out of this. Any second now, and Stucky would be knocking on the door with his axe like Nicholson in The Shining.
More or less, yeah. Whew! Finally. Batteries?
I wasn't about to open the door, as long as I was liable to catch an axe with my forehead.
Good idea, Ryan. Finally. Ooh, phone.
It's the latest.
Yes.
Right, Paul, Sheriff. Oh, may I?
Roman!
Hello?
Hello?
Oh.
One stone!
The spirit.
I think that's an understatement. Where is that gonna hit? Mother of fish! Hell yeah, I'm getting out of this thing! I feel like that, what's that guy's name from Pirates of the Caribbean?
The bulldozer had gone over the cliff with the office. I hoped Stucky had suffered the same fate, but I wasn't planning on staying to find out.
Oh! I feel like Captain Jack Sparrow stuck in Davy Jones's locker looking over that... you know the scene. Thanks for opening for me! Oh, crap.
More of them.
I know I got him already, but I want to kill this guy first. Ugh! Ah, you little turd blossom!
My head pounded with a concussion. I'd never fired a gun outside a shooting range, and now I just killed someone, or something. There were no bodies. They just disappeared. If I was dreaming, it felt real enough to make me sick.
Whew.
Eerie hand-painted graffiti was revealed by my flashlight. Someone had hidden a chest of supplies near.
Nice. Who's breathing in my ear? Don't breathe in my ear, please. Please don't breathe. Ugh. Ugh. Okay. Alright, hit the button, Wick. Don't kick it. Don't kick it, you idiot. Well, touching
the dark forest was the last place I wanted to go, but I had no choice. I had to get to the gas station.
Mother of fish. Oh, I didn't know that was the flare gun. Pretty. Oh, I feel so dumb, guys. I may have needed that flare. Shoot! What happens if there's like a whole bunch of them ganging up on me? Crap. I think I just screwed myself over. Crap, man. I think I just made the game 10, like 20 times harder. Alright. What the heck was that?
What the hell was that?
That's awkward. We said the same thing.
When I saw the river below, something uncoiled itself inside my head. I realized that I'd have to find a way across. I didn't even want to look at the water.
Whew. I'm guessing this way. What? Oh, Stucky. Does that guy ever give up? Ooh.
Stucky was still out there, in the dark, stalking me.
I figured he's out there stalking me. Man, the audio in this game is so nice. Give it up to Remedy. They do a great job with atmosphere. Still all. I have no ammo for the flare gun. I had a feeling in my sternum. I had a feeling when I was walking here because there was too many bushes. See all the bushes, guys? Like somebody can easily sneak out from behind those and try to kill me. Come on, Wake. Oh, another one? Yes. Another case? Awesome. Up. Okay, then.
Taken. They're taken.
Okay. How's that breathing again? Still no more ammo for the flare gun. Terrific. I'm afraid if I jump from this height, I may kill Alan. Because he's that of a squishy pin. He breaks easily when wet. Ugh, the sound.
The staircase was broken. I had to make my way up some other way.
Alright. Alright. Still no more ammo, because it didn't pop up. Ah.
There was no power. There was bound to be a generator somewhere at the logging site.
Oh, you mean that generator over there that I can see plainly through my optical vision? Vision? Guys, I'm retarded. I'm sorry. Oh, this is a great place for an attack. No thanks, I don't want any towels. Oh, sorry, Alan. Oh, crap. Whew. Click, 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 click before they come back. Oh, crap. Okay. I'm not reading it. Ooh, nice. Is that a shotgun? Hell yeah, it's a shotgun. I'll blow their balls off. Alright. Don't do that in real life, guys. Don't blow. Don't blow people's balls off. Dang, the atmosphere. All right. I gotta move it to the location. Okay. I think that'll do it fine. Nice, I made a bridge. Does my life mean something yet? No, keep working. Oh. Okay. Yeah, I got it, right. Oh, come on, Alan. Don't be such a baby. Oh, no. Oh, I was almost a baby right there. All right. spawn of Satan is this?
Well, I was just outside for a breath of fresh air, and what a night. I know most of you are probably in your beds by now, but if you're still up and around, take a moment. Step outside for a spell and breathe in deep. The weather's absolutely still. The sky is crystal clear. It's like the forest is quietly breathing along with you.
Yeah, say that again, Junior.
I'm a night owl, and it's on nights like this I wish I wasn't cooped up in the studio. Makes an old man like me wish I could just roam wild.
No! Ew!
But here I am, and it would keep you company all night long if I weren't. It looks like I'm not the only one staying up late. Caller, you're on the air.
Hey, Pat, it's Maurice Horton.
Hello, Maurice. What are you up to?
Well, I was just taking Toby on his walkies.
Oh, isn't it beautiful out there?
Sure, but Pat, the reason I called is that Toby heard something rustling in the undergrowth and took off after it, and I couldn't find him.
Probably a rabbit.
Sure. Toby loves rabbits.
Well, sure.
Anyway, I figured that, you know, if anyone runs into Toby, they could grab him. My number's on his collar.
And Toby's a friendly dog?
Toby loves people. Usually he comes back, but we were pretty far from home, and it sounds like he went pretty wild there. Great dog, but just too dumb for his own good.
Well, Maurice, it's out there now. Hope Toby comes home soon.
Yeah, thanks, Pat.
You have a good night now.
He's probably dead. Ooh, are they playing my song? Yeah, awesome. Toby! Toby, are you dead? Whoa. I need to look around more for, like, clues and stuff because... Ooh, another paper. Oh, this looks morbid. Ah, the gas station!
The gas station was closer now.
Mm-hmm.
Its light welcoming in the darkness.
Stucky, I forgot about him.
With no contest, Master Dog is second best. The famous dog is...
Oh, no. Oh, gee, I wonder where they're going to pop out from. Behind me? Okay. Oh, screw the handgun. I'm going for the shotgun. Yeah, there you are, honey. Reload, reload, reload. Reload! I forgot to dodge! Okay. I'm coming over here because I want to explore the area for, like, secrets. And there's a secret! Hey, don't throw axes. It's not nice to throw axes. Who's throwing those axes? Oh. He's throwing those axes. Crap. I'm sorry, guys. Maybe I should ignore the note.
The gas station was closer now. Its light welcoming in the darkness.
I could go that way, but then those guys are waiting for me. But there could be stuff I need. Let me think. Right is the mission. Two is the insane place. I think I'm already getting touched already, so. Darn you guys! I sensed you behind me. Oh, come on. Woo! Okay. Oh, hell yeah. Give me that. Of course it's a generator. Oh. Okay. No ammo for any of the other guns? All right. That's funny, the noise comes when I step out of the light. So when I step in the light, they fade away because they're afraid of it. What a funny mechanic. Red light. Oh boy. Green light! And they're just gone. That is very weird. Alright, let's go. Alright, I figure those guys are gonna be out here. Come on, guys. There they are. Okay, get ready for the next guy. Fish. Yeah, I felt him coming. Woo! Leave me alone! I'm just a poor writer with writer's block. My parents are dead! Just reload the whole thing! Oh, thank God. Alright, I'm gonna head over back into the light and give him more health. Is this like a clown engine? Are they gonna constantly keep trying to kill me out here? Yes. Oh, I shot the guy in the dick. I'm sorry, man. Okay. You never want to get shot in the manhood. It's not a good place. Up the note. Come on. Man, Alan, you gotta go jogging more, man. Alright. Whew! Alright, we made it. I'm guessing those light places are saving posts. What? Awesome, another one. Oh, hell yes. Alright. This time I'm gonna save that flare because I was stupid before. This time.
I never touch salad, though. A man like me needs a hefty.
I'm gonna be kind of stupid. Stucky, you're out here, buddy. We can talk about this. Just stand still and it'll be fast. I see them. I am not using the flare. That was pure dumb skill. Oh, this looks morbid. Get in the shed, get in the shed, get in the... whatever you call this thing. Yes! A new gun! Or is it the same gun? Television?
Science. It bestows immortality on those who advance it to elevate all of mankind. Newton, Einstein, Sagan, princes among men. But the price for such a legacy is steep indeed. In Night Springs. Tonight's episode, a quantum suicide.
Oh, that's right. Yeah, they actually put live TV shows in the game.
The lines are already written. It would take a courageous man to change the script. Having called a press conference, Dr. Barclay...
Yeah, you can actually watch these TV shows in the game. Courage.
Ladies and gentlemen of the press, I am Dr. Barclay Colvin, and I'm glad so many of you could join me here.
These are the people over at Remedy, I think, Institute. And they made up their own TV shows.
I'm going to give a practical demonstration of the many worlds interpretation.
I would love to watch you, but I gotta get going. Ooh, what does this thing do? Oh, I just turned it off. I sense pain coming in my future. Hopefully it's good pain, not bad pain. Come on, Stucky, I'm ready for you, big man. Stucky! There you are. Oh no! That's a lot of bad guys. Oh, I didn't kill him with the flare gun?! Whoa, Stucky! Whoa, he can move quick! Oh, I can't shoot him with the... That's right, the darkness is still on him. I gotta burn away the darkness to get a clear shot. Stucky! Gotcha! Oh, the heck with this. Dear gosh, how much health does this guy have?
Stucky's body vanished, leaving behind only a lifetime of nightmares to come.
You're not the only one.
Reach the lights at the gas station alive.
Whew. This game, it's like every time you finish something in this game, you feel like you're actually doing a victory. Alright. Oh, I gotta open it this time.
I recognized the parade float I had seen in Bright Falls when I first arrived with Alice.
It's a moose! No, not a moose. What am I thinking? That's a deer. Why am I thinking a moose? Man, I'm so stupid.
Moose. After the insanity I had just experienced in the darkness, the lights of the gas station felt comforting. At least for a moment, the sane world reasserted itself. The deer fest had been 2 weeks away when we arrived. If the day count on the banner was right, I was missing a whole week between the night we got here and now.
Whoa, so... So what... Oh crap, what happened?
The garage was a mess. It looked like someone had trashed the place, or that there'd been some kind of fight.
Really? This is what all garages look like sometimes.
Outside, there's only darkness. Outside the cabin, outside the story, there's only darkness. I can feel her presence in the dark. Just now, I could smell her perfume in the room. I'll reach her, I'll fix it up. I'll bring her back. The story will come true. If I stop, she's lost. I don't believe this. It'd been me on the TV, talking crazy. Was I losing my mind?
I have no idea if he's losing his mind or if he... Oh, what's this? Oh. If you guys want to read this, pause the video. Is there anything else for me to grab in here? Sunglasses. You can have nice style. Oh, the phone. Yes.
Bright Falls Sheriff Station.
Oh, thank God, Sheriff.
Sheriff Sarah Breaker, you are...
I'm Alan Wake, but listen, I was in a car crash. My wife, Alice, she's missing.
Calm down, Mr. Wake.
We were staying in a cabin on the island, on Cauldron Lake.
There's no island on Cauldron Lake, not since the big eruption in the 70s.
Please, I can take you there, okay?
You look like you've taken a pretty bad knock to the head. Are you okay?
Listen,
We'll figure this out. Please get in the car. We'll swing by the lake, and then we'll go to the station. Okay? Mr. Wake, have you seen Stucky, the guy who owns this place?
I realized I couldn't tell her what had happened in the forest. She wouldn't have believed me. And then she wouldn't have helped me with Alice.
Oh my gosh. The atmosphere of this game and the writing is so gripping. It's like you're watching a TV show on Netflix.
Colored clown, they call the Sandman, tiptoes to my room every night, and just to sprinkle stardust and to whisper, go to sleep.
That was chapter
Everything
one.
Is all right. I close my eyes, then I drift away.
Sorry, I have to skip Alan this. Wake. I want copyright.
I came to Bright Falls with my wife, Alice.
Thank you for coming here with me. I thought maybe you could write here.
I don't want to hear it. God damn it, Alice.
Now, she's missing.
Alice? Alice?
I woke up behind the wheel of a crashed car. I'm missing a week. I was attacked by shadowy men straight from a nightmare. The sheriff took me to the lake Alice and I had stayed at. But the cabin had disappeared.
Honey, I'm home.
Back here, sweetie. How was it?
Worst weather I've ever seen.
Oh my gosh.
You should put some coffee on. It'll warm you up.
Oh, his face looks like a freaking plastic condom. I'm sorry. It just looks so weird because the graphics look so muddy. Oh, it's snowing. I love snow.
Coffee's on.
Great. Thanks. I'll need it if I'm going to finish this by tomorrow.
Oh, that's right. Yeah. This is, I think it said this was 3 years ago. Why are they showing us before? Well, whatever. Oh, come on, open the door. Open the door, go outside, get some fresh air, Alan. Ooh, television. This is a nice apartment. Seriously, I'm not kidding. This is a really nice apartment they have here. Ooh, there's our jacket. Ah, it's locked.
Oh, hey, I just finished those cover mock-ups. They're on your desk. Tell me what you think.
No kidding. I didn't think you'd get them done this quickly.
On occasion, I can perform all sorts of miracles, my dear.
Oh, really?
Well, you seemed to think so last night.
I'm dropping that there. Okay, so, oh wow, so he makes the books, she makes the art for the books. That's, wow, you're a lucky man, Wake. Oh, and that's actually the real actor in real life who put his face in this. That's awesome. I just wish the graphics were a bit more up to date, but eh. Still looks pretty decent, man. Whoa, what's in here? A washer? Wait, they only have one washer? To wash clothes in? Oh, maybe it dries it too and washes it. Pills. Shower. Oh, I can't take a shower?
The continuing freezing rain and heavy snowfall have necessitated a winter storm warning in the entire tri-state area. People are advised to stay indoors, as many roadways are already closed, and city officials are not expecting snow crews to keep up with the weather. We're now on the third day of the blizzard, and the weather is not expected to clear up anytime soon.
Oh, all right, so they're stuck in their apartment. Oh, wow, I can go in here too? This is very weird. Where's all the clothing? Seriously, where's all the clothing? This is their condo, right? Their apartment, right? There should be clothing inside that closet. Something weird's going on here. This feels ominous. All right. Ah.
These look really good.
Oh, sure, until Barry gets his hands on them. Which, by the way, will happen over my dead body. The last time was the last time. Oh, and speaking of Barry, he called. Alan! Alan, please check the fuse box.
I'm right here.
Oh, that's right.
I'm on it, honey.
That's
please,
right.
Please hurry.
I know. Okay. Flashlight.
Honey, it's a power outage. I've got the flashlight.
Okay. Hi.
You okay?
I'm sorry. It just really spooked me.
Don't worry. We'll just break out the candles.
Oh, yeah, because she has a phobia.
But it's just... especially when I'm not prepared for it, you know? It gets to me.
I love you.
Tell me a story, Ryder.
Okay. I used to have these nightmares when I was a kid. The dark really spooked me, too. When it got really bad, my mom gave me this old light switch. She called it the clicker.
The clicker, huh?
Yeah. If I ever got scared of the dark, I could just flip the switch and a magic light would scare the monsters away.
Oh, sure.
Here it is.
Alan.
Maybe it'll help you too.
Yeah, nice story, Ryder boy. You made that up right now, didn't you?
No. Seriously.
I love you, even if you are a liar. Thanks for this.
Feel, Mr. Wick? Any nausea, disorientation, anything like that?
Well, I shot a man.
Mr. Wick, how are you feeling?
Feel fine, okay. Sir.
My head's fine. I had to lie about my headache and memory loss. He'd send me to a hospital for tests. I couldn't leave without Alice.
Very well. I don't think you have a concussion, but you've obviously been through quite a shock. You should take it easy for a couple of days.
Thanks.
Well then, Mr. Wake, we're done here. If the pain gets any worse or you experience any other symptoms, you should come see me. I'll let you get on with it then. Sarah, Sheriff Breaker, is waiting for you. She's very good at her job. I'm sure she can locate your wife in no time.
Doc Nelson was the image of a small-town doctor. Sheriff Breaker had called him to the station to take a look at the cut in my head.
Okay. Ooh, nice guppy. That's a big fish.
I'm sorry you had to cut your morning fishing short for this, Doc.
Oh, she's a beauty, ain't she?
Whew.
Not the biggest I ever caught, if you can believe that coming from an old fisherman like me. But she's right up there. Now, she's a largemouth bass, which is what you're after if you prefer a lure. Now, if you want either trout or salmon, on the other hand, then it's fly fishing for you. You a fishing man, Mr. Wake? Oh, doesn't really matter, I suppose. But it can be very relaxing out there. You can't get me off the water this time of year. Closest thing to heaven.
Can I eat it?
I'll take your word for it, Doc.
Can I eat it right now? His back is turned. He won't know. Hit him over the head, Wake. Take the fish.
I believe you'll find the sheriff in her office. Just go down the corridor.
Shh, I know. I want to explore the area first. Can't touch anything. But that woman again! Paranoid about the lights.
You're testing the lights, Miss Weaver. Everything seems to be fine.
I don't have the luxury of being complacent, Deputy Grant. The bulbs will need changing soon. You can't change them in the dark.
A I'll be sure to take care of it, Ms. Weaver. Have a nice day.
Okay. What's in here?
Come in, Mr. Wake. Your phone's on the desk. The battery was dead. It's charged now.
Oh, okay. If I touch that, it's probably going to be a cutscene or something.
Phone, Mr. Wake?
Fine.
Have you started looking for my wife yet?
Ooh, okay.
My men are already on it. Now, can you tell me what happened?
I'm not sure. I can't remember. We were arguing. I walked out of the cabin.
The cabin on Cauldron Lake? How did you end up at Stucky's gas station?
I wanted to tell her what had happened last night, but I couldn't. She'd lock me up. Excuse me. I need to take this. Hello?
Alan, please help me.
Alice?
Stop talking to the law. You'll do exactly what I say if you ever want to see your wife again.
Who is this?
Go to the back lot. There's a hole in the fence on the left. Look inside the junker. I left a little something there to convince you we're all on the same page here. After you ditch the cops, you're going to meet me in Elderwood National Park. There's a spot called Lover's Peak. Midnight. Don't do nothing stupid, pal. We're watching you.
Oh, he sounds very cheerful.
Mr. Wake, can I help you with anything?
I need to get some air. The sheriff said I could go out back.
Of course, Mr. Wake. You can get there through the cell corridor. Just don't mind Walter in there. He's one of our regulars.
Okay.
I thought he quit drinking for good.
Oh, no such luck. He went on a bender and beat Danny pretty badly. He started shouting like that the moment he woke up.
Yeah, it's Mulligan here. I'm at Stucky's gas station with Thornton. There's no sign of him. Over.
Wait. Yeah, this is Thornton. Look, we've located the brain float. It's here. That's some good news, right? Stucky was supposed to be driving it at the rehearsal today. Over.
Oh, give me that. Mulligan here. Looks like someone really thrashed the garage. Over.
Okay, roger that, guys. Keep looking for Stucky. James out.
Who's yelling?
Hey, you! Can you help me? Can you turn the lights on? Thank you, man, thank you. Hey, you're all right. You're a good guy. Don't let anybody tell you different. You know, I shouldn't even be in here.
Yeah.
The cops, they got it all wrong, see? Sure, I beat him up, but I wasn't drunk. I mean, I wasn't drunk at the time. I only got drunk afterward. Okay, listen, you gotta listen carefully now. Here's the kicker. That wasn't Danny. No, sir. It only looked like him. You wanna know who it really was? I'll tell you. It was a goddamn space alien! I know it sounds like something a drunk would say, but believe me, I wasn't drunk then.
Just fall over, buddy. Just fall. You won't remember this when you wake up in T-minus 15 hours.
I told him, yeah, well, I don't hear.
In spite of its human mask, to describe the dark presence as intelligent would have implied human qualities on something decidedly inhuman. Nonetheless, it found the one spot in the diner that was dark enough. Some light spilled into the corridor, ravaging it. But it took the pain. Horrible as it was, the writer would soon fix that. He would be coming to the one place where it still had power.
Yes.
The early morning light hurt my eyes and made my head ache. The man on the phone had said, go through the fence on the left.
So this fence. Right? I love the way he jumps. Alan, you need to take some jumping classes, man.
Alice's driver's license had been placed on the front seat. The collar meant business.
Barry?
Ow! Thank God! Where the hell have you been? I've been trying to reach you for a week, you and Alice. Oh, I've been worried sick. I flew out yesterday. I'm here in Bright Falls.
Barry, listen to me. I'm at the sheriff's station. Come and get me. I can't talk now.
Ow. the hell is going on?
I had to get the sheriff to let me go. I needed to get to Elderwood National Park to meet Alice's kidnappers.
Alright, makes sense. But how did he get Alice? Because I thought Alice was like in the lake. Did he find her body? Is she still alive?
Well, folks, it's been another long night, and it's about time for me to sign off for a while. God knows I need my beauty sleep. Just one more item before I go. It's been a busy night for the sheriff's department. We've had a few broken windows, even a report of shots fired on Main Street. Deputies Mulligan and Thornton had to deal with two intoxicated young men who were celebrating the completion of their Deer Fest float. Now, folks, we get this every year. I know it's exciting that the big day is almost here, but let's save it for the party and leave the gunplay for the shooting competition, huh? There's no point in getting all worked up yet.
Ooh, boy. He's asleep. Ah!
A writer is a light that reveals the world of his story from darkness, shapes it from nothingness. The way a sculptor carves a statue from a block of granite. If I stop, the world I'm making dies. Darkness will reclaim it. It's a long, hard journey into the dark. Alice's life is at stake, but I can't think about that, or I'll lose it. The dread lingers at the edge of perception. I'll push on. Anything is possible here. I'll write the story. I'll save her.
So, I think it's fried.
Marvelous, Sarah. I just wanted to settle all the damage.
Oh no, it's Dick.
Inadvertently caused on their recent and regrettable little outing. They are not accountable for their.
Not him.
Are you feeling any better, Mr. Wake?
No offense to
I'd
the
like
actor.
To leave. Am I free to go?
Well, we still need to talk about.
Am I under arrest?
No, of course not. But I need to know where you'll be staying so I can get in touch with you.
I'd avoid the motel. The Majestic is known for its roaches. The cabins at Elderwood are pretty nice, though.
That sounds perfect.
I'm Dr. Emil Hartman. I'd like to invite you to stay at Cauldron Lake Lodge.
Did you talk to my wife?
I had the pleasure of discussing your situation with her on several occasions.
Did you set something up with her?
I invited her here. My clinic is a place where...
Oh, thank God!
Oh, my!
Take it easy!
Yes! Hit him again!
Hey, nobody move! Get your hands off of my client!
Who are you?
I'm Barry Wheeler, his agent. If you have business with Mr. Wake, you talk to me. You yokels won't know what hit you once I sick my lawyers on your asses.
No harm done, Sarah. I'm all right. I don't want to press charges. Mr. Wake, my offer still stands.
Get me out of here.
Oh, I want to deck him again.
What the hell was that about, Al? We don't need a replay of that thing with the paparazzi. I thought they were going to lock you up.
I had to talk to someone. I told Barry everything. He thought I was certifiable, but when he heard about the manuscript, I had him. The fact that I'd written something, even if I couldn't remember it, was enough for him. He smelled money, and he believed that Alice had been kidnapped. Anything beyond that was another story. I had a midnight appointment with the kidnapper in a place called Lover's Peak, somewhere in Elderwood National Park. The plan was to rent a cabin.
I don't like it, Al. I don't like any of it. It's not good. In fact, it's the absolute opposite of good.
Mr. Wake!
Whoa, why is she here?
You found him.
Hi, Rose.
Oh, wow.
Come
on!
I was
talking about you, too.
Great.
I was just bringing Rusty some coffee. He's on the balcony, looking after Max. Poor thing. I really need to go. Great to see you again, Mr. Wake. Later!
Who's Max?
What an airhead.
Jeez, Mr. Takes a Swing at Everybody. This is not her fault. She's a very nice girl and, more importantly, a fan. She even has a fan site dedicated to you. And she was very helpful when I was looking for you. Seriously, Al. What you were saying in the car? Just listen to yourself. What, you shot a guy? And his body just disappeared? When was the last time you slept? Are you high? Have you been drinking?
No! Look, Barry, I'm missing a week.
and someone's got Alice.
Do you understand what it sounds like when you say stuff like that?
It's not that bad.
It's a good story, could be a bestseller. But when you start confusing fiction with reality, you're buying yourself a ticket to the funny farm.
All right, wait here.
All right, then.
Easy there, boy. I'm almost done.
Hey, Rusty, right? You rent cabins.
Oh, Mr. Wake. I'd shake your hand, but mine are kind of full here. Actually, I'm sorry about this. Would you mind grabbing the registration form from the desk? It's just across from Bucktooth Charlie.
Okay, sure. What happened?
Crazy poachers. Max here got his foot caught in a trap. They're illegal to use here. Hell, you're not supposed to hunt within the park at all. But that doesn't stop some lowlifes.
Oh.
Well, at least Max is gonna be okay. He got lucky.
Oh, man.
Max is still groggy from the shot I gave him, and I'd rather not leave him alone just yet.
Seriously, Al, you can't just go and meet a kidnapper. Those situations always end up in disaster. You gotta talk to the cops.
She's my wife, and it's my call. Can we talk about this later?
No. This whole thing... Listen, you hit your head. I mean, geez, Al, come on. You gotta understand how crazy all this sounds. If you're trying to pull a joke on me, freak me out, it's working. Ha ha, let's have a laugh on Barry. Well, you had me going there real funny, Al. You can quit it now.
I think this is the form you wanted.
And here are the keys. Okay, you're all set, Mr. Wake. Glad to have you staying here.
Thanks. Can you tell me how to get to Lover's Peak?
Oh, sure. It's at the end of the nature trail. Just follow the paths, you'll get to it eventually. It's an easy walk. Nice spot, too.
Okay.
If you have any trouble finding it, just keep your eyes on the radio mast. It's right below that.
Oh, Grin, the demonic fog is very ominous.
Look, Al, you're asking me to believe that you shot a dude who went poof into thin air, a guy who was bulletproof until you pointed a flashlight at him. You hear that from people who end up spending time in padded rooms, strapped to their beds, wearing white shirts with too long tangled up sleeves, and eating a healthy diet of pills. Al, you make cruel jokes about people who believe that kind of stuff. You're the skeptic. You gave me an hour-long lecture on homeopathy last month. What was it? If there's no proof, it's pure bullshit. Period.
Guess the laugh's on me, then.
Al, come on! I mean, okay. Okay, maybe something weird happened to you, okay?
Well, thanks for the heartfelt vote of confidence.
All I'm saying is you gotta throw me a bone here, bestseller. What would you think if it was me? There's no way you should be going out at midnight with a gun!
No one asked you to come here, Barry. Either work with me on this or go straight back to New York. Your choice.
Mm-hmm. Let's give him a decent question. Can I explore this? Oh, why does every door in this place have to be locked? Oh, fine. I know, Barry.
That's just crazy talk, Al. Al? Al? We should go to the sheriff or call the FBI?
Damn it, Barry! They'll kill her! This is not a goddamn debate, Barry.
Who's he?
I'm going to Lover's Peak. He said to come alone.
Okay then. I understand. You're my best friend, and I'm worried that you're not right in the head. Tell me what to do to help, and I'll do it.
You stay here, and if I'm not back by morning, call the cavalry.
Achoo! Achoo!
Just be careful with the natives, Al. These yokels are dangerous. Everybody hates a tourist, or it'll be deliverance all over again.
Achoo!
Bless you.
Oh, this place is trying to kill me. I'll bet there's mold in here, spores, poison ivy, God knows what. This is so not worth
a 50% commission. I love Barry. He's a character. Anyway, guys, I think this is where I'm going to cut off for right now. Thank you all so much for watching. I'll see you all in the next video. Please like, subscribe, and you all have a wonderful day.